इतना सफर, कुछ होने में और बहुत कुछ होने में इतना सा फर्क है, एक बार सोच के छोड़ देने में और लग के कर दिखाने में, मान लेने में कि जिंदगी ऐसे ही कटेगी, और सुबह 4 बजे उठ के सोचने में कि अभी तो बस शुरुआत है, किसी मैगजीन को हाथ में लेने में और उसी मैगजीन की कवर पेज पे होने में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है, वीआईपी सीट में और उसकी पिछली सीट में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है। वो जिसका मैदान ही खुला आसमान है, वही कल जमीन पर तो था, पूछोगे तो बताएगा वो पंछी, ये एक दायरे में सिमटने में और पूरी दुनिया को दायरा बनाने में बस इतना सा फर्क है। इतना कितना है, इतना है या इतना है, जो नापेगा वो जाने कि जहां धरती और आसमान मिलते हैं, नानकुर से दूर अगर मगर शायद से दूर, वहां भी दोनों में फर्क बस इतना सा है, धरती और सातवें आसमान में फर्क बस इतना सा है। ये एक अंतर प्रेरणा है, ये हमारी आपकी हम सब की अंतर प्रेरणा है, एक कदम, एक छलांग, एक बाजी, एक गहरी सांस और एक ललकार खुली हवाओं में कि हाँ मैं बना हूं उन फिजाओं के, कि हाँ मैं बना हूं उन ऊंचाइयों के लिए जो ऊंची तो बहुत है पर नामुमकिन भी नहीं, क्योंकि मुमकिन और नामुमकिन में बस इतना सा फर्क है, धूप छाओं में फर्क बस इतना सा है। तो बस चलिए फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया के साथ ये फर्क मिटा देते हैं। फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया, 20 years of ideas.
Good afternoon, one and all. Franchise India team welcomes you to this special webinar series. We welcome each one of you to 224th edition of Business Opportunity Over Chai webinar series. Franchise India is Asia's largest integrated franchise solution company, which was established in 1999 and has a complete authority on franchising, licensing, and retailing. We have helped thousands of investors in selecting the right business internationally and domestically for their franchisee expansion with our 70 plus offices. And we truly claim that no one sells more business than us. We realize India. Gaurav Maurya, who is known as the father of franchising, is an entrepreneur and author. And we also welcome our second panel member, Ms. Chaudhary. She's founder at Franwork, and she's leading the team of strong business consultant. This party which we are representing today is Happy Zone, and we welcome each one of you to the wellness wonderland. Happy Soul, a one-stop shop for all your premium quality products and services in various sector of wellness. Brand Happy Soul is known for health hygiene, home and lifestyle products, and various other products. And we welcome Ms. Pooja Bedi. She's a founder at Happy Soul. She's a well-recognized media personality. Thank you so much, Pooja, in today to share your business model, franchise model with each one of us. We welcome you.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you, Pooja, for joining us. It's a very special webinar to have a very special guest with us. We all know Pooja very well, and we all have seen her in the entertainment space. Now we're seeing in a different avatar altogether as an entrepreneur and somebody who's a founder of a company called Happy Soul. So Pooja, before we really get started, we'd like to hear from you. Why at this stage you have found a new goal in your life, a new challenge in your life, and why the Happy Soul was found. And I know your belief, and I have a few interactions with you, the kind of belief system you have on this, not necessarily just to run a successful, financially successful entrepreneurial journey, but something really to solve a problem. And that's something which I really got impressed on. So over to you to just before we start the regular, our business presentation, we would like to begin with your journey now with Happy Soul, because we all know your one side of your life, and we've seen your success as an entertainer, but now we want to really see what is happening on your business side and why Happy Soul.
All right. Thank you. Thank you so much for that, Gaurav. It's a pleasure to be here with all of you. I'm so happy to know that health and wellness, and obviously, perhaps, maybe, definitely, I don't know me, has drawn everyone to this particular webinar. We all know that health and wellness is a massive industry. We will get into the presentation of that later. To introduce you a little bit about my journey into Happy Soul, I don't know how many of you are familiar with my lineage. The thing is, when you're a film star, people want to focus on the glamour aspect of you. People want to focus on the work that you're doing in terms of your screen time. And very little sometimes is known about the person and what goes beyond. My grandfather, Baba Bedi, my father's father, was an energy healer. And he basically has an institute in Italy, in Cittadella above Venice, devoted to his healing practices. Now, as a child growing up, watching people coming in, you know, with all kinds of physical ailments and problems and having lifestyle diseases or chronic diseases, and to see them getting healed was very unusual for me. And I questioned it all the time and I never understood it. And for me, it defied logic that people were coming in with kidney stones and suddenly 10 years later, they didn't have it. A woman who had fourth stage cancer, 25 years later, is running his institute. All these things kind of baffled me and it really increased my curiosity as to what was this alternative world of wellness and how exactly was it that, how did it work? Where was the logic to it? My grandmother, Frida Bedi, father's mother, is one of the highest ordained Buddhist nuns. There are 3 books written on her incredible life. By Vicky McKenzie, there's Norman Levine, there's Andrew Whitehead. You know, all these incredible authors have written 3 books on her life, which has been phenomenal. She's the first ordained Buddhist nun, and then largely the spread of Buddhism in the West has been thanks to my grandmother, who was very close to His Holiness's 16th Karmapa and formed her nunnery in Trilokpur, which is below Dharamshala. In addition to that, I grew up with a mother who was into philosophy and Carl Jung and Freud and Osho and Jay Krishnamurti. So, you know, I had a very interesting childhood. And I think in around 2003, I actively started researching all these alternative sciences and the concepts of wellness. You know, for us, wellness is only physical wellness. We look at it as if you're fit and you're going to the gym, you're physically fine. You're good. Yeah, you're healthy. But no. Wellness is also about your mental wellness. It's about your spiritual wellness. It's about your emotional wellness. It's about your sexual wellness. It's about your financial wellness. It's about your social wellness. And of course, it is about your physical wellness. But all of these are interlinked. So my journey began in 2003. I started doing all these courses in Usui Reiki and Karuna Reiki and Magnified Healing and Soul Temple and Shamanism. And those are the energetic modalities. And then I got to the theory of the brain, where we started talking about discussing and doing courses in NLP, which is Neuro-Linguistic Programming, and behavioral resolutions and hypnosis and past life regression, and very interesting journeys. And I got diplomas, I got certified. So all of this people don't generally know about me. So in 2016, I started a series of Happy Soul workshops, which basically took all these different sciences and amalgamated them into workshops, which I started doing for Vicky Flow, Y Flow, EO, different corporates, and working with them extensively on different forms of wellness and understanding how energy works and health works and true wellness and what it's about. In 2018, I basically decided that it was time to take it beyond a workshop space, where it was very limited to me being exposed to 100 people, 200 people, 1,000 people, etc. in a room, and take it beyond and introduce wellness as a concept and a way of life to the masses. I then started this journey of starting a website, which is very important to me, to start this wonderful website that had products on it. We were talking about health and wellness products. So a lot of people think that just going to the gym and being fit is healthy. Well, it is actually not, because it is also what you put into your system, what you're eating every day. So a large amount of what we eat has contamination, has preservatives, has GMO. A lot of us are gluten intolerant. We don't realize these things. A lot of the skincare products that you use, we don't realize that our skin is the second largest organ of our body, if you count the surface area. And everything that you're applying on your body, be it your face or the shampoos you're putting in your hair, is all seeping into your dermis, your epidermis, and, you know, going further down and filtering down to your lymphatic systems. And all of these toxins, all these chemicals that we constantly apply, how harmful it can be in the long run, we don't even realize what it is, the damage that we're doing to our bodies on a daily basis. unfortunately, there was COVID, and yet again, fortunately, there was COVID, because during this time, people realized the importance of wellness. They realized how important it was to not just make wellness a buzzword, ki ha ha, wellness is a fancy word, but they really wanted it as a way of life. It is the one industry, which is a $6 trillion industry globally, that India has a 500 billion share and is growing at a 30% CAGR. Now, those are huge figures. Now, when people are unwell, they will turn to wellness, because at the end of the day, they want to be well, they want to go and, you know, use every possible method available to them to become okay. And when you're well and you're healthy and you're happy, you still want to turn to wellness, be it spas, massages, pamper yourself with good products. So whether it's a bad time or whether it's a good time, this is the one industry that is constant and consistently growing. And I realized that there wasn't a single person, a single brand out there that actually symbolized wellness as an umbrella. You have Baba Ramdev, who does Patanjali. You have different sometimes celebrities and other institutes that are focusing on yoga. You have people who are dedicated, like Luke Coutinho, to nutrition. You don't have one person that is an umbrella for wellness where you look at it and say, yes, if I look at this particular brand, I know I will have wellness in all its forms. So Happy Soul started as becoming this wellness wonderland. So if you currently go on my website, you will see products, you will see services, you will see travel, you will see recipes, you will see blogs, you know, everything to empower you in your journey of wellness. Now, coming to a retail level, again, was extraordinarily important to me, because there are so many people on so many ground level realities that need access and exposure to these products. Now, when you go on a website, say, for example, you want to search a product and maybe go to Amazon or Flipkart or Nike or, you know, Sephora, wherever you go to buy your stuff, you will click on a product and you really like it. Then it says organic on it, but you're not sure, is it really organic? Is it not organic? And then you kind of zoom on it, click another image. Sometimes other images are not available. You have to take their word for it that it's organic. And you kind of zoom into the thing and zoom in to see the credentials. Is it USDA certified? Is it Lacon certified? And most of the time people claim a lot of things, but it's not authentic. It's not actually certified. Maybe they are organic, but they're not certified organic. So for us, the quality, the trust became very important. So on our website, we vet everything. Every vendor that is a part of Happy Soul is somebody that is qualified, certified, and trusted for their products and what they claim on their packaging. So that again became a very important factor for me to bring across vendors, the best in India. We have such amazing companies doing such amazing work in our country, and they're just undiscovered. We know the big ones because they're on the big platforms, but there are thousands of vendors out there that are doing phenomenal work across every price bracket. A lot of people feel wellness is unaffordable. A lot of people feel, oh, these fancy products, organic products, are niche products. That's not true. You can find a face wash at 100 and something, and you can find a face wash at 1,000 and something. It depends on the price bracket you're looking at. And for us, the important thing is curating vendors across the board. So somebody in a smaller town who has smaller budgets is able to put on their shelf products that appeal to their demographic. So these things were very important to me in terms of the supply chain, the vendors, and also most importantly, the consumer, and catering to their needs and introducing them to the world of wellness. Because at the end of the day, it is a cliche, but health is wealth. And if you have one shop you can walk into where you know no matter what you touch, be it a food item, be it something of hair and beauty, be it a home decor item, everything is not just good for you, but there are things that are good for the planet. There are vendors who believe in recycling their products. There are home decor products that believe in sustainability. You know, and it's all accessible and everything is in your budget. So why would people not want to have or be a part of the future? You know, I know during COVID, a lot of people suffered greatly. I know a lot of retailers, for example, suffered huge losses because at the end of the day, they had, you know, they were in a situation people didn't want to, if it was expensive, people didn't want to buy into big brands. People were saving their money, conserving their money, you know, and a lot of brands didn't have the footfall to, you know, to basically sustain their rents and all sorts of things. Here is a particular product that we have called a Wellness Wonderland, where everybody will walk in and get something because it's their daily need. And that's the beauty of it. It's not a luxury item. Wellness is not a luxury anymore. Luxury is a reality. Luxury is a necessity. So we're catering to large markets and large audiences where everyone needs something on a daily basis. And that's the beauty of Happy Soul, making wellness affordable, making wellness accessible under a large umbrella.
Absolutely. And I think it is a great thought. And McKinsey report says that one of the big changes in the overall world has happened, and health has taken that position. So health has now become the one very important agenda for everybody who's living and everybody wants to change their lifestyle is, and wellness is very, very important. And you've done, you know, obviously your learning come from your parents and grandparents, and I think their own structure and then your own belief system. And you've been also yourself practicing for now over 2 decades. And that's that shows that kind of commitment of what I call living the brand. Once you start, you can only use an opportunity to entire.
And this is the business brain behind it, Gaurav. You know, I always laugh and say from my mother's side, I got the Banya blood. So, you know, the Bengali and Banya mix. I'm like, I got the business brain from there. And of course, I was a class topper, which of course nobody knows because, you know, celebrities are supposed to be dumb. And, you know, when I do my courses and I'm talking about quantum physics and Newtonian physics and I'm combining the two and, you know, introducing people to various sciences and talking frequencies and energies, and they all look at me and say, but you're so smart, but you're a celebrity. Celebrities to be smart, which is very hilarious, but it's nice to be able to show people different aspects and facets to yourself.
And also it comes from a network. I know a lot of celebrities, I don't want to name, but they've all come and endorse, but they don't live the brand. They don't really belong to that. They don't change their own lifestyle. And you've taken a very, very important step in your life when you're already successful. At a certain stage, it sounds like a risk also. A lot of people look at you and what is that particular thing which you really felt that this was the time where you want to really plunge, take the plunge, and you started your store and your operations out of Goa. And you really believed in them. People don't know that you started investing heavily in building these capabilities and also the capabilities of a lot of other vendors who now supply to Happy Soul. Because they might be smaller, but you identified them and brought them to better distribution and better branding. And now Happy Soul is ready to take the opportunity and share. And it took a lot of convincing from Franchise India to Pooja, because she was very nervous because she didn't want to bring other investors unless and until she was very prepared. And she very clearly said to Franchise India, the mandate is, I don't want just somebody who's looking at a short term. So unless and until somebody belongs to the culture, somebody who has the same belief system, somebody also comes with the same mission, then only she would like to have a partner. So this is an opening point. And now we can go to a small presentation. Pooja, if you can run a small presentation. And then Sonia and I would take a lot of questions from you. I think the audience will also start asking their questions.
All right. Great. All right. So welcome to Happy Soul, which is my wellness wonderland, as I call it. It is truly a wonderland because there's so much happening in there. Now, for some reason, I cannot... Yes, here we go. All right. So let's first start with our brand philosophy, which is, again, something that is very important to me. I know that Gaurav has very wonderfully said that we want to franchise and partner with people who share our belief systems. Now, a lot of you may just be retailers and maybe a lot of you are new to the world of wellness. That's fine. If your interest lies in wellness and you would like to explore the world of wellness, not ki ha ha commercial project hai ya ha ha celebrity factor hai, but if you're really intrigued and if you are a person who is a retailer with no knowledge of wellness, say for that matter, but your interest is there to further the cause of wellness and you're like, yes, you know what, I really want this as something, not just because it is the future or because it has great potential or because it has great returns, but also because it's something that will change people's lives. If that's the headspace you're in, please welcome aboard. We have enough training materials to train your staff. So in case you're worried about what your staff and how will you train your staff in wellness, etc., we have brochures, documents, everything ready, enabled to enable your staff and your support teams who are going to be present in the store to understand what it is that wellness is and share that with every customer that comes in. So our focus is there. Our focus is our first point, that all our curated products and services are of the highest quality and from trusted professionals. So our vendor manager, for example, will go out there and source 10 brands in the day and look at them and go through their credentials and source, you know, who is actually of value. If they say they're certified organic certifications, we will therefore contact them, ask to see their certification. See, a lot of them have the certification, but they're expired and they're not valid anymore. You know, so we want to check that as well. We have situations where they claim to be 100% natural, but you look at the back, you examine their ingredients, you realize that there's certain ingredients in there, like a perfume is just added in there, and you're like, no, that is not natural, that does not belong here in our shelf. So we may just find a vendor that we really like, but we may just take 10 out of his 50 products. We may say, sorry, only 10 of these products are really valid and fit our brand philosophy. So the focus is there. The curation again comes in when we want an assortment. So again, What affects you in wellness is what you put on your body. So everything in terms of your hair, your skin, and everything that's topical and surface, what you put into your body, which is basically you're talking about, you know, the foods you eat, the things you drink, the supplements you take. You know, if you're taking ashwagandha, what quality supplement of ashwagandha it is, spices. What quality of those spices are you actually putting into your body? Now, you know, how organic is it? How trusted is it? A simple thing like haldi can be so diluted. You think every day you go to the supermarket, you pick up a local brand and you put haldi in your honey and, you know, you have it every day thinking I'm doing so much good to my body, I'm having haldi and honey. But if it has preservatives in it, you're doing yourself more disservice than service. A lot of times, you know, people have haldi thinking that, oh my God, it has curcumin in it, and curcumin is a new superfood. Not realizing you have to have half a kilo of haldi to get 9 nanograms of curcumin. It would be easier for you to take an Amsarveda mouth sanitizer spray that contains a concentrated dose, take 3 sprays in your mouth, and it will not just go through your digestive tract like haldi will, but it will actually go and absorb into your epithelial skin, go through your mouth, it will go into your bloodstream, and directly go to the parts of your body that need healing and that need the benefits of haldi and curcumin. So there are various ways to approach wellness. So again, curation is very important for us. The quality, like, you know, we would never, for example, stock the local brands which are uncertified. We would definitely perhaps go with Earth Reserve that has a certain quality haldi. Also in terms of medicinal haldi, a lot of us think that haldi is haldi and it has medicinal value. But the truth is that haldi grown in certain biotopes, which means certain regions of a forest, make that haldi resilient because of the flora and fauna that's around it. So say, for example, you have a haldi that's growing in a lab or in a nice, cute little greenhouse and they're growing haldi. It will not have the same qualities and properties as a haldi growing out there in the wild, which basically is exposed to all the elements and it builds its immunity and builds its resistance. You then absorb the properties of that immunity and resistance and fighting spirit that that haldi has because it's grown in that environment. And those are the qualities you're ingesting. So there's so much to do with the world of wellness that, you know, therefore we have the concept of trust. So we give badges to companies that actually are certified. So when you're doing a search on our website, you know which companies have actually got the certifications for it. So, you know, when you go to a website, as I said, you scroll in, you zoom in trying to find the thing, you see the Happy Soul Organic badge, you know, all right, Happy Soul has checked it out for me. This is definitely organic. You have to go no further than watching that badge on a particular screen. So we're committed to organic, 100% natural, gluten-free. A lot of us have gluten allergies, not realizing how bad it is for us. A lot of wheat and meat, things that we have are filled with gluten. And a lot of people experience lethargy, brain fog, lack of energy, you know, body aches and pains, not realizing it's gluten-induced. So a lot of times we encourage people to just start a gluten-free diet. We're like, just go onto a website, pick gluten-free food, just replace it for like a month and see what differences occur in your system. So that's really amazing for people who go on a gluten-free diet. And we sometimes say, if you could do gluten-free, dairy-free and sugar-free for just a month, and tell me at the end of the month, what happens? People are amazed at the energy levels they receive. You know, the lethargy goes, their face starts glowing. It's phenomenal. Then keto seems to be the new culture. Not that we advocate keto as a diet, but people who are into the keto culture, which is a very big culture, we encourage them to go about it the natural way. So, you know, if you're going to have keto products, which are high fat, low carb, let's go in for the good quality products. So at least you're not damaging your system along the way. Eco-friendly is very important to us. So whether it's our products, we really get happy when our vendors have eco-friendly products, recyclable products, though that's not always the case. But even our home decor is sustainable, things you can use and reuse. Animal cruelty-free, their products have animal cruelty-free badges on it. So you feel good about giving back to nature, society, the environment, etc. Ayurvedic badges, grassroots empowerment, very important for us, you know. A lot of people want to go out there and help people. Now, there's two ways to go about it. One is give me a fish, I eat for a day. Second is teach me to fish, I eat for a lifetime. So a lot of people believe charity is giving people food. Yes, it is, empowering them for that day. But if you teach them to fish, if you encourage their job, if you encourage them by giving them revenue, by giving them income streams, you're allowing them to earn the dignity of earning for themselves, which is so important to be able to stand on your own 2 feet. So we have companies like that as well, you know. So it's really wonderful to basically take that forward also through Happy Soul. Then, of course, just minimize this part. We have community, which I talked about earlier. So it's all about planetary wellness, personal wellness, social wellness, all of that comes into the picture. So basically, we are looking at being a one-stop shop of the premium quality products. And premium does not mean expensive. Premium means it's across every bracket, but quality in every single price bracket. So whether there's products, whether it's retail, whether it's services, whether wellness travel, where we promote all kinds of retreats where you can go for a spa holiday, a detox holiday, an Ayurvedic holiday, and all of that. Wellness centers, wellness cafes, wellness festivals, wellness awards. We have a YouTube channel out last week, so we started getting our spiritual series, our mental wellness series have started, wellness e-commerce. So basically what happens is you will now be part of a large community. You're not just a retailer with just a store that has no meaning apart from a brand value. You are now part of something that is a global experience. When you retail with Happy Soul, you become part of a mega community that basically supports you through every vertical. So when we have the name Happy Soul being built, it's not just products, it's cafes, it's wellness centers. And yes, we have a model in place as well for if you want retail, come cafe, we have a concept for that as well. Wellness centers will come up. And I mean, I want it to be that you look left, you see Happy Soul, you look right, you see Happy Soul, you look up, you see Happy Soul, you look down, you see Happy Soul. And you just know wellness equals Happy Soul. So you become part of this community that basically is empowered. We'll have wellness awards for the best retailers, for the people who are spreading the word of wellness. You have festivals. We will have, you know, where people can come and they can participate. So it becomes a very wonderful feel of being part of something much bigger than just a retail store. And that's what comes with franchising with Happy Soul. Our e-commerce portal will be up as a B2B2C model, which will be launched, I think, by May. And that's going to be really, really mammoth. And that's really going to spread wellness to the country as well. Competition mapping, as I said, it's incredible, but there's no single multi-vendor chain. Yes, you have people like, say, for example, Vanity Wagon, who are an online platform. Who basically focus on something called clean beauty. But where's the, you know, we have more than just beauty. We have foods, we have home decor, we have candles and incense and essential oils and all sorts of other things as well. So it's very well-rounded. You have Nykaa, Sephora, but again, it's not dedicated to just wellness products. You have all kinds of chemical products there as well. There's no focus on the identity of wellness. So technically, we're the first players in this very gigantic space on a very gigantic level. So the good part is that people who pioneer get to establish themselves, brand themselves, and have that distinct authority of saying we were the first literally in there, and the brand grows from strength to strength. We then have our brand USP, which we spoke about earlier, which is our curation, our categories, which are multiple, community, which is what we're creating, not just with people out there, but also with our own Happy Soul community members who are going to be franchising our retail stores, our wellness centers, the e-commerce portals, our cafes, and all of that comes into it. Our badges, again, is very important to us, and that really defines us because it sends a very strong message out when you see that badge that this is something that has been authorized, approved, and it is accredited. So our product mix is wonderful. We are constantly sourcing new products, new vendors. We're always on the lookout. We get enormous numbers of inquiries from people wanting to stock with us. Of course, we're very choosy because we stand for something. It has to be in keeping with our brand philosophy. We have health and hygiene, so feminine products. We have deodorants, sanitizers, immunity boosters, supplements, which are very important again. So ashwagandha, we have organic wellness. We've got a whole bunch of companies that are just really good for these supplements. Home and lifestyle is a really big one also, because we find that in our Goa shop, for example, home and lifestyle, candles, and all of that tends to go really, really fast. Candles are the thing right now. And again, when we come to candles, just to give you an example, how it fits into wellness. You can have a candle that's essential oil based and say, for example, you think, I'm going to have a lavender candle to relax myself. And what you're actually inhaling is a paraffin candle with essential oil of lavender. That's not healthy. So our candles are all soya wax. They're made of soya wax, vegetable wax, or beeswax. So what you're inhaling is pure in every possible way. So we have incense. In fact, we've also started our own product line, so therefore that becomes even better for our vendors. We're going to keep increasing our product line as well, because that adds to better margins for our vendors, for our retailers. So that works very well for us. So right now we are into candles and essential oil, incense. We're slowly getting into crockery, our own home decor, and also our own, you know, coasters. We already got coasters out, but we're really, really looking forward to expanding our product line from massage oils and all sorts of other wonderful things. But essentially, as of now, we are multi-vendor across the country, which is to me the most important thing. Our food and drink, we have a whole food and drink section. We have a lot of things that are very normal and day-to-day, so you will always have people walking in for the day-to-day stuff. We have a massive supermarket right across us in Goa called Oxford. And say, for example, they will stock Pure and Sure, and they will stock a certain other company like Prakritik in their huge supermarket as well. Yet the same customers will come across to Happy Soul and want to buy those products at Happy Soul. Because they get not just those products, but they get a whole variety of other things also, from black rice to beetroot flour and spinach flour. And, you know, they get this whole assortment. So it's really interesting because you'll have olive oil sold at the supermarket, and yet they'll want to come to Happy Soul to buy olive oils, because it's also the store experience. Our store experience is so important to us. People come in, there's a certain playlist for the morning, a certain playlist for the afternoon, a certain playlist for the evening, you know, depending on people's moods at different times of the day and, you know, their shopping needs. So it's really interesting, when you create that kind of space, even visually how our store looks. It's all white and gold and pretty, and it's clean and it's airy and it's friendly stuff. So that's very important. And again, hair and body products, again, very fast selling. And holistic products. So we have people who supply us gemstones, and we explain what these different gemstones do for you and what their role is. And it's really interesting. It's a very interesting product mix. We then have the beauty of multi-vendor products, having all price brackets. So, you know, in smaller towns and tier two cities or tier three cities, you may not have people wanting to spend $1,000 on a particular product. You may want them in the price bracket of, say, 100 rupees to 250 rupees or 300 rupees. So there are vendors that cater to every demographic. So whether it's a tier one city, a tier two city, or a tier three city, you know, once you know your customer base, you can cater to them very easily and very quickly. And as I said earlier, we're very focused on Make in India and growing that entire community as well. So you feel really good having a store that's promoting everything that's great about India. Partners, there's my darling Namrata Thakkar. I don't know how many of you know the story, but she basically met me at my spinning class at a gym. And she basically asked me what I want to do. And at that point in time, she was involved in women empowerment and women's movements and things like that. And she wanted me to speak at a couple of functions. And I told her, I said, now that I have this dream of Happy Soul, I really want to start this company called Happy Soul with these workshops. And she said, Pooja, just do it. I will support you. I will put together the entire event. I will do your branding. I will do the marketing. I will get in your sponsors. I will do everything for you. And I said, yes, I'll let you know. And every time she'd meet me at the gym, maybe once a week, she would say, so Pooja, where's Happy Soul? And this went on for 2 years. And I kept saying, I'm not ready. I'm still learning. I'm still growing. I'm still formulating it in my mind. I'm taking this forward. After 3 years, she was like, Pooja, it's been 3 years of me asking about Happy Soul. Where is it? And I said, you know what? You're right. And I think I'm ready. Let's do this. And we kept a 3-month target, and we launched our first workshop where she did everything from start to end, including the sponsorships, and I offered her a certain percentage of the entire experience, and she refused to take it. And she then launched my second workshop with me, which is on spirituality, then the next one, which is on teenagers and, you know, teenage empowerment. She never, ever took a penny, no matter how much I would push her, no matter how I would implore her, you know, and she just would not take money. She said, Pooja, when you give me 30 crores, I'll come on board. And when I started Happy Soul, Magicians of Wellness, which is our company together, Magicians of Wellness, I said, Namrata, here's 25% of my company, and just come on board. Just come on board. This is my gift to you. And so she's a partner with me today, and she's an amazing, dynamic woman who is, she heads an entrepreneur community of over 70,000 entrepreneurs. She's a huge influencer in digital marketing, digital warrior, and all sorts of things. So she's a wonderful, wonderful soul. And I'm so grateful to her, for really giving me the impetus and constantly being after me to realize my dreams. I'm so grateful. Me? Well, you know all about me. So right now, the model we're looking at is franchisee owned and franchisee operated. Right now, we're not in the co-co mode. No, right now we're starting as franchisee owned and franchisee operated. and the beauty of offline stores for us. Please notice a very cute visual that my design team has put on Happy Soul being the central cute little shop out there. It's so sweet. I love attention to detail. That's very important to me. Firstly, the quality assurance. So a lot of people say, oh, but if you can get it online, why would you come to a retail store? Well, you would, because online you cannot smell a candle. There's so many times you order a candle, either it's too small when it finally comes to you, or it's just not smelling the way it should smell, or it's cracked, or it's broken, and you have all sorts of return issues. Here you go in, you walk in, you see a product, you smell a product, you apply the oil on your skin, you get to, you know, see the soap, you get to see, you know, read, and, you know, it's just a wonderful experience to actually go shopping. Also, it's a very social experience, you know, because you're going with friends and you're, you know, constantly talking about what to do, whereas online shopping is a very lonely experience, right? So the store experience, as I said earlier, you know, the vibe, the staff, the music, the way the shop smells with all our incense, and, you know, the attention when you ask a question. If you go online and you want to buy something, there's no one to ask, like, hello, you know, could you tell me about this product? Is it good for my oily skin, or is it good for my, you know, if I have diabetes, what should I be taking? You know, those you'll have to Google separately, then you'll have to come here. Here, you have an employee who's attentive, who's there for you, who will answer your questions. And yes, we train your staff. We give them manuals. So they, you know, go to these manuals, they learn. So it doesn't matter whether they're, you know, into the world of wellness, they will learn. Our first store, which opened up, that's Happy Soul. That was at the beginning, you know, a happy experience. We put a lot of detailing into the handwork on the particular, you know, on those doors. As you can see, we had artists come and paint it up for us. And, you know, that's our Happy Soul. It's all about bougainvilleas and dragonflies. And I have a huge connection with the dragonfly. Our logo, if you zoom into it, is a mandala of dragonflies. It's actually a very long spiritual journey I've had with the dragonfly. We'll get into that later. You know, our store, as you can see, is all white and gold, and it involves, you know, a lovely curation of products. It's a very tiny store, but we're doing very well. The financial dynamics of all of this, of course, are very important. Obviously, being franchisees, you'll be very keen to know what the financial dynamics of this are. You know, we have an entire financial chart out here, which you can look at. I'm sure that Franchise India will share all these details with you. You know, in terms of what the revenue margins are, the expenses, the royalty, the employee costs. They've done a very wonderful detailed presentation with me. They went through every detail. They went through our statements. They went through our figures. They sat and understood what it costs to create a store like this and put it up. What are the miscellaneous expenses, you know, the POS systems. It's been a really wonderful journey with Franchise India, who've handled this so professionally and given us a whole model as to how to put these on Excel sheets and present it to you. So yes, we're really happy to share this with you so you can take a close look at it in terms of what our models are for 500 square feet stores or 1,000 square feet stores. Generally, it ranges between 44 lakhs to about 65 lakhs, depending. It can be a little less, it can be a little more, depending on, you know, the styling that we adopt and use. Certain things will be fixed expenses. Staff expenses are also variable, as you know. We put it at a certain thing, but your staff costs may be higher. Maybe your interior costs will be lower. These are all variables we will work with. As long as the look, feel, vibe, and ethos and philosophy is intact, we're happy to partner with you. You know, so there's a model for a 500 square foot, 1,000 square foot. Also, in case you ever want to have a cafe attached to it and a larger 1,500 or 2,000 square feet situation where the cafe takes a certain part of it, and we have the facilities to put all that in place for a Happy Soul menu and all of that. We've got all that sorted. These are the kind of cities we're targeting as of now. If you don't happen to be on this list, we'll be very happy to still take a look and see the feasibility of it, because we want everybody to make money. We don't want people to come in and be disappointed. We want people to come in and we want everyone to have a fulfilling experience with Happy Soul. We want to know that it works for us and that it also works for you. So essentially, we're looking at malls in certain cities which have high footfall, high streets in certain cities, and airports and five-star hotels in different places as well, where we know that it will have that kind of demographic that would be interested in those kind of products, and you would definitely have an income stream coming in from those sources. We have a partner profile, generally 30 years or plus. Doesn't matter to us whether it's male or female. We just need to know that if you have an existing franchise with beauty and wellness brands, all the better, because your staff are trained in things like that. You know, we are looking at people who are basically interested in the world of wellness. So whether you're a property owner who's keen to invest, you know, whether you want whether there are new investors out there. You know, basically, we're looking at people who are looking to earn money also. I think it's very important. I think we should not negate commerce in any of this, because essentially it is a commerce experience. It is something where people are looking to earn money, and why not? It's not just about saying we're doing wellness and we're doing good for the world. We have to earn money along the way. That's very, very important to all of us. Nobody's in it for the love of things. Yes, you are, but what beyond, right? And we all have our expenses, we have our dreams, we have our own visions. And hopefully, Happy Soul will help you realize all of that and more. We have support functions. They very sweetly said, no, you must write Celebrity Association Pooja Bedi. It makes a big difference when it's the brand and that you're a part of it. So yes, the support function is that I am the founder of the brand. And obviously this is something very close to my heart, and obviously something I will put hugely across my social media, which has about a million people across Twitter and Facebook and Instagram. Collectively, it's about a million followers that I have that will be exposed to every single franchise that I do set up. We will obviously help you with the interior decor, accounting, billing systems, marketing. Of course, that's our strength. We will obviously help you with ideas, creative support, event creation, get opportunities for you to participate in our festivals. We'll help you train your staff, inventory planning and management, what's best suited for your demographic. And yes, as you can see, this man putting money out there, because at the end, it is about money, money and money. And nobody should have money blocks. And the more you earn means the more you sell, which means the more you are helping grow communities and the Make in India brand as well. So it's a wonderful trickle down effect that goes both ways. So basically, yes, it is one of the fastest growing industries. And we are going to be the leading name in the world of wellness, because there is no competition as a wellness umbrella as of now. You will enjoy being a part of our network, which is incredibly important. We have years of research in curation, product quality checks, a very, very able team. As is obvious, you will have revenue from day one. In fact, with us in our Goa store, we hadn't even launched. It was the day before the launch. We were setting up the store and people were walking in and saying, do you have bath bombs? Can you please buy bath bombs? And things like that. So it was just really sweet to be doing sales from before we even opened. That was just really wonderful. So it is, as we keep emphasizing, the fastest growing industry is a $6 trillion industry. And yes, we love you to share this journey with us. And that's where we are right now. And I'm going to, how do I stop sharing this? Stop share. Here we go. Yay, here we are. All right, Gauri.
Thank you. And really impressed with the story you present with. So it also shows your passion for the. Let me summarize what the opportunity is. As Pooja said, this is a integration of all the products and services. There's no other player than Happy Soul in the market, which is offering both complete product line and also a lot of services along with it. And there is also integration of a cafe if you want to do that. And we'll come down to even more detail on that. But there are five different categories which are available in a single store. When you open up a 500 square feet store, there would be five different categories. It would be health and hygiene, home and lifestyle, food and drinks, which is a very big vertical. And there's nobody who's actually curated all the food products, supplements, and so on. So there is obviously a personal care and also holistic products. All these pieces come together. What Pooja and team has done is that they have put a lot of hard work in actually aggregating different manufacturers. Most of the manufacturer would have limited SKUs. So they have gone and checked everybody's performance, their product certifications, their quality, the organic certifications. A lot of other work has been done to get the finest at the best pricing, because once it is finest, and second also should be because it's a lifestyle thing you consume daily. So fundamentally, it has to also come in the right price. So that aggregation, no other company in India has done that. Even online companies don't have the full selection available. So this becomes your destination store where you get everything if you belong to conscious living and are also about wellness and holistic living. Then this is a store to go to where you will get everything which you need or your family would need. Also, another area which is a big advantage, which it comes with me, because it is backed by Pooja herself and she's so involved. She'll also make sure that every store which gets launched, from the pre-launching, getting your early subscribers. Please understand that this is a subscriber-based business. So if I go to a store and I have a, as a conscious customer, I like right the product, I will continue to come to that store. So what with coming with Pooja is that once she opens up store, you don't have to tell. If you open up a store in Ludhiana, the day the store opens up, everybody who's a conscious customer in Ludhiana would 100% know that the store from Pooja Bedi has opened in that market, which means that she will make sure that everybody who's there would once come to your store. And if you deliver a good service, a good experience, this customer is going to be with you for life. So that's an advantage which a lot of other brands are not able to do. I know a lot of people who open up the stores, it takes a lot of time. It takes a hell of a time to really get their store be known in the market to do that. What it does with her is that if she sends one thing, look, I'm opening up my next store in Ludhiana, who's joining me on my opening. Even if that one message goes in, you're done. You don't need any other marketing. Everybody who's in the kind of consumer base we are looking at would be at your store. So that's a huge advantage, which a lot of other brands don't bring in. So if you are a retailer or somebody who has experience in retail or has a strategic property or willing to be a part of this journey, you can go on a Q&A box and apply, and Sonia would then pick up this structure. Yeah. I will start with a few questions with Pooja and more, because I know the subject about the brand, but on the interest of our audience, I'll take some questions to get some answers from Pooja on the business opportunity. Pooja, as a business opportunity really is today as divided into few components. And from a financial viewpoint, I'm talking about, there is a franchise fees, which is 10 lakh rupees. There's a stock, which is your working capital, which is fast stock is about 15 lakh rupees. Your interiors and the furniture you do for the store with the shop improvement is another 15 lakh rupees. These are the three big components. And you have a launch, small launch fund, which you would spend for your launching. And you also have to have some IT technology equipment, your systems and softwares and things like that. So that's a pretty much the component. The 15 lakh rupee stock is given at a wholesale price to the customer, which would have a much higher MRP price. So given 15 lakh rupees, you're talking about a 23, 24 lakh rupees of MRP pricing product available in the store, which is a very well stocking. So what is the supply chain structure, Pooja? What would you have experienced in Goa? Now you're running, and that's also why I like, because a lot of time, and you know, a lot of other celebrities who've not invested their own money to start and they start franchising and they come in. I think I liked about what your business is that you are very well invested yourself. And you wanted to run your own store like any other franchisee and experience that. You would have done a fancy store in Bombay and brought all the celebrities and created a more buzz about that. But you actually chose to do a store in Goa and run like any franchisee would run and see the success of the store. And then only you're giving that, because sometimes what you present is very different. And when it goes to a franchisee store, it's a very different experience. So you actually run exactly the store. You want every single franchisee to run that yourself. And now you're giving that. So in your store, which is very stocked.
Sorry, go ahead.
How much is the supply chain cycle? How many times you would feed the store? So the franchisee has to get every fortnight supply chain or every month supply chain?
Okay, so to answer your questions, yes, for me, it was very important to actually understand the dynamics of something before I introduce it to the outside world. So I need to know it well in order to go out there and say, yes, this is something wonderful, you should do it too, right? So that goes with every aspect of my life. Even as a product, I will try it on first and then say, yes, it's something wonderful and you should use it too. And therefore, I'll endorse a product as a celebrity, you know, no matter what I've chosen to endorse along the course of my life. So to me, of course, product curation was key, because every market has a different demographic that they're looking to target, right? So certain markets are looking at smaller pricing, like Goa is a very price conscious market. Okay, Goa is a kind of market where you know that people will come and they will not want to spend huge sums of money. Yet at the same time, we have certain things out there which cost a lot of money, but they're more eclectic and more for gifting purposes, because we know people will in Goa spend on gifting, but not so much on personal care. Right now, you know that if certain products are, say, for example, basmati rice or olive oil, etc., these are things that are staple across all communities. They will come, they'll want their olive oil, whether it's a supermarket across or whether it's us, they're going to pick it up no matter what. Okay, so we know that. So, you know, in terms of skincare, hair care, we're very aware of who comes in for what and to watch the cycle of customers, what was selling fast, what was not selling fast, how fast was baby care going, how fast was food section going, you know, if we had products that were similar to what was across the street, how fast was it going compared to other products that weren't in that store, but we had separately, and how, what were the differences in, so for me, that whole analytic space was very important to understand consumer movement. Okay, and to understand a consumer headspace and to be interacting with customers. And I realized that when you have good staff, we have customers who come in sometimes on a daily basis, sometimes on a weekly basis, you know, but they, or a bi-week or once in 2 week basis, but you always come back. They come back because of the space, the feel, the vibe. They come back because the staff have now got to know them well. They're offering them tea and herbal tea and asking them to taste different things. And there's this interaction. They feel special. Right? That's very important, I've realized, to people when they go out, because people go out for a social experience as well. People go out because they want to interact. Otherwise, they would sit in the confines of their home and order online. So the important thing is a human interaction. So for me, the staff training comes first, because that enables the customer to have the experience to come back and also to experience different products. How well you explain the products. You know, if you see 10 products on a wall, there's a primrose oil, jojoba oil, argan oil, this and the other. A customer walk inside and say, oh, I don't understand all of this. And you look at the back to see what is argan oil, what is this? Well, they come inside and the staff asks you, so what are you looking for? You know, and was this, oh, I have pimple problems and this and that, oily skin. Immediately they said, why didn't you try this? Why didn't you try this? And look, argan oil is good for this and primrose oil is good for this. And they have brochures in front of them that teach them that. You know, it's so much easier to relate to your customer, you know, and to make their shopping experience a fulfilling one. So for me, the important thing was curation. That was number one. Number two, in terms of the supply chain, again, very important for me to have a trust with the vendors that I know that they supply on time, they supply good products. What is their return policies? How easy is it to deal with returning stuff to them? What are their ethics regarding that? So these things, again, became very important to me. So all the vendors that we have current experiences with, especially when they know that you're franchising now, they are on best behavior. You know, they are open to returns. They're open to, you know, damaged products come in immediately. There's a replacement sent in. Ideally, what I do with my Goa store is I do a 1 month cycle with them. Like, I just buy a whole bunch of stuff. We have office warehousing. So what we do is we just buy stuff and we just warehouse it, you know, and as and when stuff depletes off our shelves, because our shop is rather small and certain things go really fast and certain things are also seasonal. So certain markets in Goa are very seasonal because we have a large tourist season that comes in November, December, January, February. We have a very different market. So again, you have to keep those factors in mind, especially in a city like Goa. So again, it became a wonderful challenge for me because normally in a Bombay, it'll be the same customer base over and over and over again, irrespective of a season. Same would be Ludhiana, same would be, you know, Delhi, same would be all the big metros because it would just have a same kind of customer cycle. Goa was very challenging and a great learning curve for me in many ways. I tend to do it on a monthly basis, but if the stores feel that they would like a faster turnaround, we have facilities for that. Essentially, what we will be doing is we will basically be taking the orders that you place. We would encourage you to do it at least every 2 weeks or every month. You know, that is just better for billing purposes. It's more streamlined and clean. We would, of course, take your orders, pass it on to the vendors, and the vendors would ship it directly to you because they're multi-vendor across the country. For us to have huge warehouses and stock from thousands of vendors makes no sense. We will enable you to get it from the vendor and the vendor will send it directly to you. We're monitoring the whole chain. In case of any issues with the vendor, we will obviously step in and make sure those issues are sorted because we're dealing with them on a consistent basis. So you get all our support through that as well. You know, in terms of payments, there's payment modules worked out, you know, the times of payment. Certain vendors, you know, after a couple of cycles with you, develop trust and they will give you assignment basis and have 30 day later payment systems once they develop the trust in you, you know, which is wonderful as well. Certain vendors will want their money up front. Certain vendors will say, as and when it sells, pay us. You know, the different styles of vendors also that we deal with. You know, so we have all sorts of options available, especially once you do a couple of cycles with them and they develop that trust with you. It works very well.
Yeah, I appreciate. This is good feedback. So just for our audience, the retail store has four components to it. One is what we call destination product. Second is called specialty product, which we Happy Soul would have, which other stores would not have. Then we have seasonal product, which comes in a particular season. We overload that because we know that this is going to move very fast. Say around Christmas, you will have a lot of candles being sold. It's just a normally that's a structure. And then you have impulse product. We are there in the store and you like something, you buy it. Again, from a business viewpoint, there are staple products which create a subscription-based buying, which is your food, your personal care. You start using a food, you would weekly order and come and buy your entire thing. Personal care, you would do on a monthly cycle. And then you have a margin driving product. So margin driving products are your holistic products, which is your other things which are private label to you. So a lot of big private label category is being built by Happy Soul, which is going to drive your margins. So it might do 80-20 for you. The 80% of products give you smaller profitability because they are already brands and brands give you lesser margin. But there is a private label strategy which gives you enhanced margins on the entire. So same customer, once you start dealing with them, they would continue to upgrade their purchase decisions and would start buying that. And the cycle of buying is monthly. And Pooja is a special case, which a lot of people don't do actually, is passing that vendors directly to you. So you are able to get the best pricing possible. Because sometimes when you are buying through a centralized warehousing, there is an additional cost comes in. And she actually, I was rather insisting her that, look, let's do a central. She said, no, I would like to pass that benefit to my franchisees and let the franchisee get that. And not somebody who would like to hide away where we are doing that. We build a culture of transparency. So while they have worked very hard to source all these different suppliers, but she would like to pass as much benefit to the franchisee. So that's a good move.
Also, you know, the important thing about buying monthly is shipping costs, because every time you ship a certain amount of product, you're paying a shipping fee. So sometimes it's better to buy it in bulk because the shipping costs come down. And once the shipping costs come down, it becomes that much more profitable for the person to, you know, to have that product in their store, which is why I encourage monthly buying versus, you know, as and when you need 5 products, you're calling for it, you need 10 products, you're calling for it. It's nicer to do bulk purchases for that matter as well.
No, it's very, very helpful. And now I'd like to invite Sonia. Sonia, if you want to take some questions, because a lot of questions are coming from some specific locations where people want to open up. So over to you.
Thank you so much, Pooja, for this wonderful presentation. And I would say the manner you presented and talked about it, I can't wait to go online and order the stuff. And while you were talking, I also happened to glance through one of the outlets that you run in Goa. I must say it's very beautifully designed. And a lot of detailing has gone in that outlet. And Pooja, while I'll start with the questions, maybe I'd like to also, you know, put a perspective and ask, you know, today the industry has gone through a huge transformation. And, you know, you've seen how it has evolved from a very unstructured beginning in the 1990s to maybe more competitive ecosystem today, which includes consumers, providers, facilitators. So what are the changes and key trends which you have witnessed that are shaping the industry, which includes the customer preferences, maybe how they have evolved, changed, and maybe the new set of TG that you're seeing are adopting and, you know, coming?
Are you talking specifically about the world of wellness?
Yeah.
Okay. So in the world of wellness, we've seen dramatic movement. Okay. Firstly, in terms of not just the demand, but also the supply. You know, the fact that there are so many vendors today that are focused on conscious living, on wellness products, developing different product lines. In fact, when we're looking at expanding our own product lines, for example, you know, the number of vendors that have come forward with the most incredible products we would need to compile, like say the best essential oils, the best coconut oils, the best base oils, you know, to create a great massage oil. We're seeing a massive shift in people wanting health over everything. So firstly, the customer is king. Okay, we have to realize that. If the customer wasn't buying, nobody would be producing. So the fact is the customer base today is one where they are so focused on wellness, which is creating that $6 trillion industry in the first place. So firstly, figures don't lie, statistics don't lie. So when you look at the fact that you have a large consumer base looking for those products, you need products to cater to them. Now, the better your product, the better priced your product, the better packaged your product. Again, that is very important to us. What may happen is you may have a phenomenal product, but if it doesn't look nice, it's not at Happy Soul. You know, because we believe that visually also it has to be attractive. There are a million products out there. We bifurcated down to X number, which is as it is overwhelming. Maybe on our website, you may find those products which are not as attractive looking. You may find those there. But in the store, it is a very important experience to also visually see something and how beautiful it is and take that home with you. So that is again a real focus for us in terms of curation for retail stores. The industry itself, as I said, it's massive. The figures don't lie, statistics don't lie. The growth is 30% CAGR that is being experienced in the world of wellness. It's tremendous. And the fact is, Happy Soul is across all the verticals. Retail is one vertical of wellness. We then have our e-commerce, we have our wellness centers, we've got our cafes, we've got our product line, we've got our YouTube channels. We're kind of building this huge umbrella whereby everything is amplified. Now, the more people hear of something, it's not just about it being a trend or a fad, it's a go-to name. So you're not just saying, oh, today this is trendy and tomorrow it's not. It becomes a go-to destination, becomes a go-to name when you are selling something or you're purchasing something. It becomes a kind of space where vendors want to sell to you because they know that being presented on that platform gives them value. You have customers who come in that turn around and say, wow, I got a product from Happy Soul. The bags are cute and everything is cute. And, it's a whole experience that goes into it. For us, that's very important. The market is phenomenal, as we know. The quality of the products that we have available to us already in the market, phenomenal. The upcoming companies as well, people are always contacting us saying, I'm coming up with this line, I'm coming up with that line. It's incredible to see the attention to detail and the fact that each vendor is tuned into a consciousness, that each vendor knows the target audience it seeks. Like there's a vendor called Organic Kashmir, okay, who has white honey from the Lolab Valley, then they have saffron infused honey, and there are markets for everything. I mean, I have people coming in, the foreigners especially, who come in looking for that saffron honey all the time. And we just keep selling out this particular thing. So we keep stocking it because we know it's in such high demand. It's a foreigner base because foreigners are really abundant in Goa, and that's the kind of exotic stuff they're looking for. So it's all about know your customer as well. Wellness is a huge industry. You have to know your customers. You have to also know how to educate your customers, those who are not into wellness, who would like to get into wellness. So a large part of being a retailer is also information that you dispense to your customers to make wellness something that they really want to be a part of, and also something they understand very easily, and also something that is not intimidating by virtue of a price bracket. So these things are very important for us. And there's nothing but a win-win situation in the world of wellness. They say when you're ill, you'll turn to wellness. When you're doing well, again, you'll turn to wellness. Much like alcohol, as I joke and say, when you're sad, you sit down, have a drink. When you're happy, you want to celebrate, you'll go have a drink. So wellness is on the same space. So it's a good
way. Yes. And I quite, like what you've done is you've made it very, very inclusive also in terms of your price range, which makes it very inclusive for a bigger audience to come and experience your products. And education, which I feel is the most important aspect, because a lot of people who are consuming also would not know what the product can do and what solutions they would need for maybe a problem or for their wellness.
Yeah.
Great. Pooja, you're a very successful modern woman. You have a strong lineage, you mentioned, and you've also navigated through multiple roles and diverse roles, both in personal, professional life and level. And now that you're entering a new world of entrepreneurship and wellness space, and you not only passionate about it, but you also done a lot of study and also practicing on the subject for very long. And as we start scouting and selecting partners for your venture, I would want to understand which is the most important aspect for you, which you want in your prospective partner, or maybe traits that you think or believe will make them successful in this venture.
All right. So essentially what I'm really looking at are people who have vision. Okay, not people who say, chalo, ek dukaan kholte hai, dal dete hai saman andar, but people who are driven by vision, people who want to do well. Okay, not just keep, you open a store because it has glamour association, but they've opened a store because they generally want to do something with their lives, and they want to put something out there that will not just change their life, but change other people's lives in every possible way. Something that's committed to grow, development, wellness. And today, wellness is such a big word. The fact is everybody is turning to it. So imagine being the person who's the face of it. Imagine being somebody who's in a city that says, listen, you guys want anything to do with health and wellness, my shop is the shop to come to. Just come and I will tell you everything you need to know to have the most healthy life. Somebody who's passionate about spreading wellness to his family, to his friends, to his community, who makes his shop, somebody who's aesthetic, somebody who understands what it is to enter a shop, somebody who's a shopper themselves. Because once you go into a store, you know the experience. If you walk into a little Reddy Dukan, what is the experience? If you walk into a Louis Vuitton, what is the experience? If you walk into a Happy Soul, what is the experience? What are you offering people? The warmth, the vibe, the friendliness, the support. Somebody who has those qualities, of being a warm person, because that will reflect in their store. That will reflect in the ambience. Somebody who has heart. You know, I'd love to partner with people like that. You know, people who are dildar, people who have heart, and people who, you know, who want to tell the world and show the world and, you know, bring that into their lives and bring their communities into it. That's the kind of spirit I'm really looking for.
Absolutely. Great. Pooja, what I'll do is I'll take some questions. I understand wellness, universe is the place to be in, but I'm saving some specific inquiries in the chat box. And, you know, maybe if you can also say and mention if there are any priority locations for you to enter. I'm seeing locations like Nasik and tier 2 locations like even Rajkot, apart from cities like Bombay, Delhi, Bangalore, Hyderabad, and many other tier 1 locations, which I see.
I'm interrupting on Sonia. There would be very, very special partners in Mumbai, because that's where the magic can be the very, very big. Because if you open up a store, which is Pooja's store, and she can bring in a who's who of every the society, the not only just the Bollywood, but everybody who matters would be part of that. So the selection of Mumbai store is very, very special, where we want to really put that. I mean, somebody wrote the Powai. Powai is a beautiful location. Powai can be probably the best location. And I think if you do a good store in Koregaon, or a Kalyani Nagar in Pune, a very, very good location. A Jubilee Hill store in Hyderabad is no-brainer to me. A good store in Indira Nagar, High Street. A small store. Don't do a big store, but do a small store. Very interesting. Or maybe add a little cafe. What you can do a cafe in Bangalore, because of weather, and if you have a little outside sitting, nice place, a nice cafe would do very well. If you are in Kadar Nawaz Road in Chennai or in a T Nagar, again, with a nice small cafe, can be doing any store in Chandigarh would do very well. Surat, good, maybe VR Mall is a good mall there. Interesting space. You can do a nice atrium space, where we can do some small cafe with sitting and a store can be a very good opportunity to do that. So there is a humongous opportunity in these markets. But you need to really see how you want to plan that. Ahmedabad, I would also say do a cafe and a small store, because people really like to come and sit, experience.
Yeah. You need to actually also, Gaurav, have a look at, when we talk about cafe, whether the demographic really likes that kind of food, you know, which is healthy and smoothies and oatmeal and sandwiches and, you know, presented a certain way, etc. So you have to also check out, the demographic for people and the kind of food you're presenting and what would be the turnover of people wanting that particular thing, and study in comparison the other restaurants in the area that have similar style stuff and see what their kind of growth journey has been. In places that you mentioned earlier, like Nasik and Rajkot, etc., again, you'll have to have a very study of where to place it and who you're targeting for this particular thing. Because I think, again, it's very, very important to know that you'll have high turnover of people. Not just the odd person that walks in who sees Happy Soul, but something that caters to that region and that area specifically. So I think in places like Nasik and Rajkot, we would personally like to do a study of what is going on, in Rajkot, what are the demographics clientele that would walk in, because, you know, we want every franchisee to succeed. We want every franchisee to either be placed in a particular place or have a product curation that will appeal to people. So that will take a lot of effort again from our side, which we are happy to put in, but we need to know that is a workable model, in because we don't want our stores opening and shutting. And that's not what we want.
Are also available. The travel locations are very, very good and interesting. There is a lot of private airports now coming in. Ahmedabad is getting a new airport, which would have a lot of international flights. So
that's,
you can
wonderful.
On the departure side.
That's a big one, yeah.
That's a big one coming in. So there is a lot of good airports which are coming in. Airports is a very good destination for Happy Soul. And do even a smaller store, not even 500, it can be 100, 150, 200.
The cost of everything go down dramatically based on that as well. Correct.
So now over to you.
So another question which I'll take is from Vimal. He says that, are there any delivery charges for sending the product into stock? And what happens to the non-moving products? You know, is there a policy of a replacement of these stocks?
So generally what happens is, if something is not moving, the vendor will take it back, as long as there's no 6 month. Like, generally vendors tend to say that if there's 6 month expiry left on the product, then post that they will not take it back. So any products you have that are reaching a point where there'll be a 6 month expiry time, please back if you feel it's not moving, otherwise happen like a 25% thing, which doesn't make any sense for you because that means it's a loss. So what matters to us is to know that products are moving. Your first couple of consignments, you will kind of see what's moving, what's not moving. And chances are, if it's not moving well for you and it's moving well for us in Goa, we'll just say, listen, send it over to us. We'll sell it and we'll reimburse you the money for it or return to vendor, et cetera, et cetera. You have our full support in the entire chain because we want you to succeed. We want you to have a good experience. You know, as far as defective products, of course, it will be returned. You know, they will bear the courier charges for it to come to you if it is defective or you know, marred in any manner. That is their responsibility to make sure it reaches you in good condition. You know, and as I said, we build a good rapport with our vendors. So what happens is, it's not just the one Happy Soul they're selling to. They're selling it to multiple Happy Soul retail stores over time. They're selling on our e-commerce platform. So for them, that business, their reputation is very, very important to them as well. And of course, every vendor is different. Every vendor comes in with their own rules. Every vendor has their own, ye chalega, ye nahi chalega, aisa karna, waisa karna, you know, and we don't expect you to know them all at first, but we are there to guide you through that. We are there to oversee and we are there to make sure that it's fair no matter what, you know. So that's very important.
Great. Another question which I have, you know, because we have a multi omni-channel approach and we have almost 2,500 odd diverse product portfolios from multi-vendors and also a private label strategy that you have. Now, between these two, what is the mix of private label and the multi-vendor?
Right now, as far as our personal label goes, we have only, I think, coasters and candles and incense sticks out. So right now, that's where we are at. We're obviously going to develop our product line incredibly during the course of this year. And again, it doesn't matter whether it's a Happy Soul product or whether it's a Prakritik or whether it's a Amara Naturals or whether it's a Soul Tree. It doesn't matter. What sells is what should be on your shelf. So whether it's a Happy Soul product that's selling, put it there. If Happy Soul is not selling in your shop, don't put it there. You know, we would very much like for a range of our products to have a particular stand because we know it will sell. We know that we put products out there that are price competitive. We know we have fantastic quality products. Whatever it is that we are developing has class, style, great packaging and very consumer friendly and pocket friendly. So that's our intent. It's not like we priced Happy Soul at an exorbitant amount and we keep it on your shelves whether it moves or doesn't move. No, that is not us. We want to be accessible, we want to spread wellness, and we know we can only spread wellness when we are price conscious as well.
Absolutely. Yeah, I see a lot of questions which are coming in and we might not be able to take all of these. Maybe last question which I want to take is on the offering, you know, from online and offline. Would there be a differentiated offering for an offline store? Or would that be a new launches first happen offline or they would be happening together one? And will the franchisee get benefit of any orders in their radius or city? How will that work? Is there a specific radius which is given to them one? And will the, you know, he get a benefit of the orders which come online? And the third question is there a differentiated offering between these two platforms?
So basically what's interesting is we have a B2B2C model approaching us in May on our e-commerce platform. So yes, what can happen is every franchisee can also additionally choose to go out there and basically what we have is a massive wholesaler space. You can choose to create your website on our website. So what you do is say, for example, if you're Happy Soul Raipur, okay, or Happy Soul Ludhiana, you can choose to put Happy Soul Ludhiana online, drag and drop products, which are not even in your shop. You can drag and drop 1,000 products into that particular website of yours and tell all your customers who come to your shop, you can also shop online at our shop, right? So again, everything is taken care of for you. You don't have to deal with vendors. You don't have to deal the supply chain. You do not have to deal with the financial part of it. It goes straight into your bank account with every sale that's made. The vendors get their share, so you don't have to worry about the billing. You don't have to worry about the tie-ups. You don't have to worry about anything. You just go open your store online and you can drag and drop into it. And so every person who comes to your store and they say, you know, what if we can't come back? Say, you know, if you have any other needs, just visit our store online and benefit from it. And you can have, you know, we have all sorts of programs to rope in your customers. In our retail store, for example, like very much like what Body Shop and all have, we're going to have a loyalty program as well, benefits to them. You know, plus once your customers get familiar with you, they will be really, really happy to indulge, you know, everything that you're giving them and offering them on multiple levels. So, you know, if you just say, go to Happy Soul Raipur online and you give them a URL, they're able to just access your website and buy what they want. You know, again, you're earning from that. So in that, of course, there's a very specific price structure. We take 5% of everything and there are no costs involved for you. So, you know, so there's an option for our franchisees to also do that. So, and you'll get a much discounted rate to open your website on our portal. So normally if something would cost somebody 50,000 bucks, say, to open a website, you could possibly open up in a lot less, and it'll be very complimentary to your retail venture. Now, retail has a lot of footfall. To get footfall on your online portal takes time. Everyone has a website. They want to reach out, ask people to come, ask people to buy something. You know, you have to put social media marketing. You'll have to do this. You'll have to do that. Whereas when you have a retail store, an online supplements it beautifully because you're giving access to every retail customer of yours, the option to go and buy something online from your store online as well. It's your store. It belongs to you. That's your space. You know, so it's a really plus for, as I said, for retailers, because they will have massive benefits of people walking past and also people who are dedicatedly buying from them on a continuous basis.
Absolutely. I think that's a very important point that you've made, and a lot of transparency when people put all the products on their, you know, sub websites, so to say, they would receive all the orders. Friends, I would request, because a lot of you are putting queries and you would like to connect further to understand maybe the city that you are looking for to open, we put our hotline number in the chat box, and I would request each one of you to kindly reach out to us. If you already have any properties that you run in any specific location, do mention the city and the location that you have these properties in, which will help us in maybe filtering the interest in a better way. And maybe sometime in the next week or towards the first week of February, maybe we'll take a week's time before we can filter the profiles and send it to the team of Ms. Pooja Bedi in the coming week. And before we leave, Pooja, you know, we would request maybe a last word or a message that you have for all the maybe prospective business buyers or first-time entrepreneurs who are all listening to you both live and on this channel today.
Well, all I want to say is, you know, you're going to be benefiting from my years of experience, number one. Number two, you're going to be wellness ambassadors in a community that is greater and beyond. So you're part of a much bigger picture and a bigger dream than just being a shopkeeper. You know, so that should really make the whole process worthwhile for you. You have wonderful support teams. You're also dealing through Franchise India. So you have a really good basis and a really good, solid person out there who's guiding you and guiding us and, you know, linking us together in a very professional manner. So again, that's all plus. You know, all I want to say is that let's do this and let's just journey together and go from strength to strength. We're here to help each other and we're here to empower each other. You know, and I'd love to be able to, you know, watch my network grow and watch all of these, you know, franchisees go from strength to strength and just see wellness spreading through the world. You know, it's very exciting for me, and I'm sure it's going to be really exciting for everyone who ties up with us. There's so much more than just being a shop, you know, that comes to them through this particular association. So I'm really looking forward to it. I'm really looking forward to these interactions and to growing the franchise for Happy Soul. And thank you for this wonderful session. You know, Sonia, Gaurav, Archana, all of you, thank you so much for all of this.
Thank you. Well, wonderful to have you. And you not only shared a great opportunity, but you shared a great belief system, which I think our audience really would also have the same appreciation. It's a great opportunity. It's a great opportunity, as Pooja said, to become an ambassador for wellness in your city. Say you take in Ludhiana, I'm just taking the example of Ludhiana. You can start with a store, you build a community, and then what you do with the community, the kind of events, the kind of awards, you can have even a wellness award only for Ludhiana. And all that can be done. So this is a community of a like-minded, conscious consumers who believe in overall well-being and also to contribute towards society. So it's a very good initiative by Pooja. We are very excited at Franchise India to partner with her and her brand, Happy Soul. And we're very committed. We have a senior consultant, Santosh Nair, who will be leading and front leading Franchise India's. He's responsible to filtering every single inquiry, seeing in the depth that would you have a long-term viewpoint on becoming a partner. And that's the mandate which Pooja has put in with Franchise India, to go out not to get investors. She gets on her because being socially recognized every single day, so many inquiries. But that's not important. She said, that's not my agenda here. Your job is to go and find out who people are really committed. And if they are committed, she would come and support completely. As you can see, she's not shying away. She's not the one who would sit at the back and tell her team to do it. She's a leader in the front. She comes in the front. All meetings our teams had, she was the one who was taking all the meetings. She was part of every single detail. I have an opportunity to work with over 100 celebrities in my life. I have rare to see somebody who's so committed and dedicated. And I'm saying this with all honesty because all others are just want to leverage their name. They're not there to really work and do that. And sometimes we used to shy away in franchising. They would say, we're trying to sell something and it's actually the celebrity himself is an absentee. But here you're dealing with somebody who's always involved, always available. So it's a great opportunity. Go and apply with Santosh. And we will be more than happy to filter your inquiry and then bring it for Pooja to final selection. Thank you very much. Yeah, over to you, Sonia.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Pooja. And I second Gaurav. And I also say the most successful companies and brands, they focus on users, not buyers. And they don't focus on positioning their brands in the minds of customers, but they position the brand in the lives of their customers. And that's what you have done for your brand. And that's what your brand really stands for. I would say very proud to partner with you and work with you to bring like-minded entrepreneurs and partners. And we wish you all the best, Pooja, in your journey of entrepreneurship.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Over to you, Archana.
Thank you so much, Pooja, for joining in today. It was great working with you even during our dry runs. You were so full of energy. Thank you so much, Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am, for giving us that information. We would like to thank our dear participants who have joined us for this wonderful opportunity. We would like to invite all your suggestions, feedback, and queries at our business hotline number, which is 97176-83838. Please do connect with us at different social handles, information on your screen. You can also join us at the Facebook page of Franchise India Brands Limited to see all the previously done webinar submits on different brands. You can also connect with management team of Franchise India at their respective LinkedIn IDs, information on your screen. And tomorrow under Business Opportunity Over webinar series 225th edition, we invite you for BeLive. It's India's pioneer in e-bike tourism. Please do registration today at the same business hotline number so that you can join us tomorrow sharp 12 p.m. And since it's Sunday and Sunday is always very special for all of us because we at Franchise India team tries to get the best of the opportunity. So we invite you for Best India Franchise Show, which will start sharp at 3 p.m. You join us to understand top popular franchise opportunity. So please do not miss chance. Do registration for today's West India show at 3 p.m. and tomorrow's Business Opportunity Over webinar series at 12 p.m. Thank you once again for joining in today. Have a great day ahead. Stay safe, stay happy, stay healthy. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Pooja.
Thanks, Pooja. Bye-bye. Take care. Thank you so much, everyone. Bye.
Bye, everyone.